from the mid-60s onwards till the early 70s, I was very lucky. I did lots of sessions playing on lots of different people's records. Some were fantastic, some were crap, probably because I played on them, really. But there were, some of the sessions were really, really memorable. And I'm going to do a couple during tonight. And hello. Hello. That's all right. Have you reached a verdict? Where was I? Oh, yeah. Anyway, right, here we go. Yeah, some sessions were very, 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 very memorable, and this was one particular. I got a phone call in 1970 from Cat Stevens, who's now Yusuf Islam, anyway, and he said, I'm looking at putting Morning Has Broken, the hymn, on my next album. He said, do you know it? I said, yeah. He said, do you fancy doing it with me? I want to do piano, guitar, acoustic guitar, and vocals. I said, okay, that sounds good. So I went on to the studio where he was, which was a studio called Morgan Studios in North London. And there was a piano, just like this one, a stool for Cat Stevens to sit on. And the only other person there was his producer, Paul Samuel Smith, in the control room. And all we had to work with was a page torn out of a hymn book with the three verses on it. And Paul Samuel Smith said, well, play it through, let's hear roughly what it sounds like. So I sat at the piano, Steve sat on the stool by the side, and we played it through, and Paul Samuel Smith said, he said, that sounds just beautiful. He said, this is going to be so beautiful. He said, the only problem is, he said, it's only 40 seconds long, which is a bit short for a single. He said, well, can you make it longer, Rick? I said, oh, I'll play it slower if you like. He said, don't be a prat. Come on. I said, well, I'll tell you what you could do. I said, you could take the first verse and stick it at the end. That gives you four verses. He said, good, do that. So we did that. He went, right, we're up to 110. He said, we're still short. And Cat Stevens said, what we need is a piano introduction. He said, well, can you work something out? So I sat at the piano, played around for about half an hour, and eventually did something. And Cat Stevens said, I love that, do that. So I put it on, and Paul Samuel Smith said, that's brilliant. He said, we're up to 135, that's great. He said, Rick, I said, what? He said, can you stick it at the end? I went, yeah. So I stuck it at the end. I went, great, that's 150. And he said, we're still short. I said, look, Paul, I'm ahead of you. He said, what do you mean? I said, it will go in the middle. He said, brilliant, stick it in. So I stuck it in the middle. I went, good, we're getting there, right, 215. He said, we're still short, though. I said, how about a key change and a few twiddly bits? He went, brilliant, do that. So I did that. He went, great, 305, we have a single. And that's how Morning Has Broken was done. Now, the one sad thing at the time for me was, back then, session fees in English money, it was only £9, and I never got paid. I wanted some sympathy there, actually. I'll try that bit again. I'll try that again. Thank you very much. Thank you.